Assalamualaikum. So, as you can see, I got a package. This got in yesterday. I've been wanting to get this item for quite some time, but I didn't find a use for it. Like, it's not that important lah. But because a few days back, my friend wanted to do a collaboration with me. So I had to do some recording of me playing my bass guitar. So I was like, you know what, let's just get this interface so that I can do my own recording. So I got this from the Apple website here in Singapore. So if some of you don't know, I'm a musician. Okay, I play the bass guitar for my band. So here is iRig HD2. So the contents are lightning and USB cables for iPhone, iPad and Mac. Precision gain control, headphones and amplifier output. So instrument input, and then there's an amplifier mono output, and then can for iPhone, iPad and Mac. And then the stereo output, volume and a bypass switch. This is the top and that's the top. Okay, so let's put this aside. Okay, so cut this up. Okay, so the box is empty. So, okay, this is the item. It has this rubber feeling, texture feeling, rubber texture. So it's nice. Since even if you put it on the table, doesn't move that easily. Nice texture. So this is the front. This is where the your instrument goes in. Is your for amplifier, right? Your gain, volume, and then your bypass. So it uses a micro USB headphone. Okay, so this, and then this one, I assume the cables. So this is your manual. Okay, so one buckle strap for you to strap to whatever. They recommend is for your microphone stand and stuff, and then the iRig itself. So two cables. Okay, let's open this. So this is a micro USB to your iPhone or iPad lah. Okay. This one is to USB direct. To USB. And now they give you to a USB-C. Since they give you additional. Yeah, see on the box it gives you 3, but on the booklet there's 2. And the clip. Yeah, I think the clip should be attached. Okay, let me register my product, attach it to my instrument and to my Mac, and then I will show you how is it. Okay, let's go. iRig. So assalamualaikum. I've been using this iRig HD2 for a few days because I'm trying to get used to the to this interface. It's really easy to use. It's straightforward. You can just plug in and play. But I had some problem with it lah. Because when I attach it to my my Mac, there was a lot of static noise. Even when recording, it was still so noisy that I got so bingit lah, kan? So I had to borrow my mom's laptop and not attach it to any power. So there wasn't a lot of interference lah. It was okay lah. Much better than using this Mac. I think that there's something wrong with the wiring in my room, because the other time when I was using a Shure mic, I had the same problem. There was a lot of static and some delays, so recording was not easy. I had to re-record again, and like this lah, I had to borrow my mom's device. So I'll show you how easy it is. So we start. I use GarageBand lah, so it's just very easy. So we start an empty project. Okay, so now it says no input here. Okay, so you just, I already have the cable attached to my computer, so you just put in the micro USB. So you see this light. Okay, it's blue, means it's on. Okay, so here you can check properly. You can check lah. So the instrument connected is under iRig HD2, and then the sound is from the built-in output. You can change it to the iRig HD2. So you just plug in your headphones here, but I prefer it to be in my speakers lah. Or I'll just fix my headphones to the computer itself. So we put create. Okay. And as you can see on my table, I have a ukulele bass from Kala. So it's very small. I can just put it on the table. Easy to show you guys. And then I just attach the bass to this end. So if you want to put it to the amplifier, you just plug in here and then you change to a through. So now it's under effects. So I turn on the volume. So you can see it's green because the volume is okay. It's green, is good. So for example, if I increase it, okay, this is the gain, right? Okay, so you can hear that the sound is breaking. So now it's orange. So now it's green lah. Okay. So yeah, I forgot to show you that I use clean bass and this one. Okay, so the sound is, you can adjust I mean, if you're used to GarageBand, then you just adjust to whatever sound that you think is nice lah. So if you wanna record, for example, okay, so let's try and have a playback. Alright, so it's easy to use, it's just prime play. The static noise, maybe because I'm using the speaker, it's not that obvious, but when I use the headphones, it's like so obvious and I couldn't take it. So I'm like, you know what, just forget about using the MacBook and I just use my mom's MacBook. I mean, I forgot, just yeah, now I'm confused already. Okay, so I really do recommend this iRig HD2. Because it's really affordable. For me, it's affordable. It's straightforward, easy to use, no hassle. You don't need extra battery or anything. You just plug into your computer, plug in your instruments, and then you just record. Okay, so that's about it for the iRig HD2. If maybe there are any other items that I would want to review and recommend, just stay tuned, subscribe to my channel, and then you can watch my vlogs and any videos that I upload lah. Okay, so thank you very much. Thank you for watching.